Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. This is lesson 2 of Media and Information Literacy. Lesson 2. Historical Overview of Communications. Before words were ever invented and used, people communicate through symbols, grunts, gestures, and mostly body language. Then, as time goes by, humans were able to form words. And then, in 3500 to 3000 BCE, cuneiform, a system of writing, was developed by the Sumerians in Mesopotamia. Flashback to your social studies in grade 9, Mesopotamia is situated in between the Tigris and Euphrates River. In modern day, it is in Iraq, a little bit of Syria, Lebanon, and Iran. Then we began writing letters and sending it through the postmail, which took weeks, even months, to get delivered. Then we have telegram, which shortened the delivery time to a few days. And then we have the electronic mail or email, and what we all have now is the instant message, which lets you send and receive message in real time for as long as there is internet connection. And then Graham Bell invented telephone, which upgraded to cellular phones and now smartphones. There are indeed many ways to communicate nowadays. As population increased and systems of travel became available, people became more dispersed. The way people passed on information changed as well. Institutions emerged and became sites where knowledge is communicated and transmitted. In 100 AD, Christians have codex which can be referred to as the prototype of a book. By 15th century, paper technology have arisen and revolution of printing took place. Johann Gutenberg invented the printing technology that would eventually be called movable type machine. Bible was one of Gutenberg's earliest creations. By 1500s, printing presses have been established in 242 cities, mostly in Western Europe. This changes the European lives drastically when information is made available in their lives. This altered the church, science, arts, and politics, which led to the Industrial Revolution in the 17th century. The first book in the Philippines is believed to be Doctrina Christiana by Fray Juan Plasencia. Rise of newspapers. The first newspaper was reported to be printed in England not earlier than 17th century. Merchants and travelers are the usual buyers of these papers since they were interested in what's going on economically and politically in other countries. In late 1600s, England's monarch was subsumed under a parliament. This accelerated commerce and naval activities, which made newspapers a regular feature in the country. By 1700, the idea of free press, independent from the control of government, emerged. Macquail in 1983 noted that the newspaper is a more significant innovation than the book. It provided information on varied topics with far less pages than a book. The development of steam engine gave rise to steam-powered cylinder press, which dramatically lowered the cost of newspapers. Today, the newspaper as a medium has evolved with the rise of internet and digital technology. In the Philippines, newspaper came around 19th century. La Esperanza, first daily newspaper, was published in December 1, 1846. From static to moving pictures. George Eastman invented the Kodak camera, helping make photography accessible to the public. His company remains one of the largest in the industry. And then, Thomas Edison and his assistant, William Dixon, who made the use of photographic film. Louis and Auguste Lumière French brothers, further developed the technology of projectors. And then, Edison debuted the vitascope. Originally patented by Thomas Armer in 1895, a vitascope is a motion picture projector which operated with a mechanism to stop each frame briefly before the lens, and a loop in the film to ease the strain. Radio and television followed very closely. By 1928, the first telecast of a television program took place, transmitting from the experimental studio of General Electric in New York City. In 1946, James Lindenberg teamed up with Antonio Quirino, and together they established the Alto Broadcasting System. First official telecast was on October 23, 1953. Here you can see George Eastman's oldest camera. He received the patent for the original camera shutter and a trademark for the company's name, Kodak, in September 4, 1888. This is an example of a film strip which, if run through a kinetograph, creates an illusion of movement. This paved the way to the modern cinematic projection before the advent of video. The Lumière projector, invented by the Frenchmen Louis and Auguste Lumière in 1895. The projector, which was also used as a camera and printer, was patented on 13 March 1895 and first demonstrated in Paris, France, on March 22, 1895. From December 28, 1895, the Lumière brothers used their device to make the first regular presentations of projected film. The rise of new media. Before, we had traditional media. Most of the information is coming from books, newspaper, magazine, radio, television, and films. In the new media, however, the channels of communication have become so diverse and easily available that we tend to suffer from information overload. There's so much information, it is imperative for us to learn which ones are true and which are not. The arise of the internet and Web 2.0 made the browsing experience customized and personalized. It seems like everything is at the tip of your fingers, literally. Just a little reminder about the dangers of using social media. There are a lot of platforms for socializing in the internet. We have to bear in mind the rules of modesty in Islam. Showing pictures to non-mahram with or without hijab, especially without hijab, is haram and very dangerous. About the extent of the body to be covered by a woman in the presence of a stranger, any male apart from the mahram, the different schools of thought concur that it is wajib for her to cover her whole body except the face and hands up to the wrists, in accordance with the verse 31 of Surah Al-Nur, and reveal not their adornment save such as is outward, and let them cast their veils over their bosoms. Quran 24:31. Considering that outward adornment implies the face and hands. Efforts on new media. In 1948, invention of transistor radio signaled semiconductor devices, which led to invention of integrated circuit. This is considered to be the foundation of modern electronics that paved way to the development of computers. In 1953, IBM shipped first electronic computer 701, 600 and 700 series. Most of the users of the early computers were research laboratories, aircraft companies, and the federal government. In 1969, ARPANET LAN, created by US military, used by Department of Defense, Advanced Research Projects Agency. ARPANET was used for military tactics. In 1971, it began the transition to the Internet. The Transmission Control Protocol, or Internet Protocol, structure proposed by Stanford University, was developed. In 1983, TCP/IP structure was universally adopted and made way to networked computers. This in turn made way to the further development of the interconnected network, or the Internet. Timeline of Internet in the Philippines. In the Philippines, the first local bulletin board system is a computer system that allows users to connect and exchange messages and information using a terminal program. It started around 1986 using a software that ran on IBM XT clone PC with a modem that ran on 1,200 bytes per minute. By early 1990s, email gateways and services broadened. In 1993, the government, especially Department of Science and Technology, with Industrial Research Foundation, launched PhilNet. By November 1993, additional budget was given in order to purchase new equipment and lease of communication lines. In 1994, PhilNet was able to connect to global internet using PLDT Network Center in Makati City. Information Age. The interconnected networks concept rose in around 1969, but the World Wide Web was fully developed in 1989. Bear in mind that the internet is the connection between countless separate servers, computers, gadgets, and multifaceted devices. The web, on the other hand, is a common area for information exchange. The web is the medium we use to access, edit, discover, share information through links using standardized protocols such as the HTTP or Hypertext Transfer Protocol. The browser is an application software which can access the internet and can render web pages. A website, on the other hand, is a collection of web pages which are grouped together and usually connected together in various ways, often called a website or simply a site. The URL is the address of the website. URL stands for Uniform Resource Locator. It includes all of the information necessary to locate the right page on the website. Domain is the address that you'll type in the address bar to access a website. For example, URL. This is an example of a URL. This is what you usually see on the address bar. This is a sample domain. Facebook.com is the domain name of Facebook, or Google.com for Google. We have already mentioned Hypertext Transfer Protocol. The difference between HTTP and HTTPS is the letter S, which stands for secured. It is highly advisable to check the URL of the sites you visit and make sure they have HTTPS on them for a safer web browsing experience. Domain names and their equivalent. Here are the most common domain names and their meaning. .edu for educational institutions such as universities and schools. .com for commercial entities. This is the most common domain name that you see in websites. .org is for non-profit organizations such as Islamic-relief.org or MuslimAidUSA.org. .gov is for government organizations such as deped.gov.ph or doh.gov.ph. .net is for the internet service providers such as dctech.net. Formats of information. Information is everywhere. Information is the output of processing or deriving meaning from a certain set of data. Some information can be in print form. Examples are books, newspapers, periodicals, manuscripts, dissertation, journals, and others. Information in digital formats or electronic format can be stored in hard drives, optical disks such as CD, DVD, CDR, CDRW, and others. It could also be found in remote or local server or the cloud. Audio and video format are materials collected using analog technology in video, film strips or reels, and audio, like cassette tapes or LPs. Do not confuse audio or video formats obtained using analog technology versus digital audio-video formats. Digital information has its own subcategories as well. Information in microform are materials that have been photographed and their images developed in reduced-size film strips, which can be viewed through machines with magnifying lenses. Historical events, old newspaper clippings, images, and models are the usual information found in microforms. That is the end of Lesson 2. See you in Lesson 3.